How soon after my hair transplant can I do PRP again? It's been 2 weeks since the procedure, and I've developed dry and flaky scalp.
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a question without a photo, but you're asking how soon after your hair transplant can you do PRP? And you've also mentioned that it's now 2 weeks after your transplant and you've developed a flaky scalp. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance based on your question alone on how PRP and something else that I'll discuss further can have some potential value in the context of your hair transplant. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we've developed using PRP as well as acellular matrix to treat non-surgically male and female pattern hair loss. And essentially, we've established a new category in the treatment of hair loss and have been at it for several years, going on to about 7 years at this point. So I think it's very important for you to understand first what is the normal healing process for a hair transplant, and then I'll share with you my strategy as to how I help patients who come to us from around the world after a hair transplant to help optimize their results. So to begin with, as far as this perception of flaky skin after the transplant, I think what you're really dealing with essentially is a combination of the scabs from the hair transplants, maybe not fully completely gone, and it's as well as this dead skin that tends to accumulate after hair transplant. A lot of patients are a little too cautious when it comes to washing their hair after a hair transplant because they're afraid they're going to lose their grafts. Well, we have been doing hair transplants for a long time, and I can tell you that really after about 48 hours, it actually takes a surgical instrument to actually make a hair transplant come out. It's not likely that would be the case. So myself and my technicians are often counseling patients on how to wash their hair properly and even scrub their scalp to get rid of these flaky areas. But this is a question that you should pose to your hair transplant surgeon as far as the aftercare, because you have to make sure that there's nothing else going on, especially if you have any history of seborrheic dermatitis, which also may potentially need to be managed. So again, the absence of a photo and additional medical history, I can't really comment beyond that. Now, as far as PRP is concerned, it is actually long overdue that the dermatology literature is actually acknowledging that PRP does have many benefits. And even though there have been thousands of articles, I've been now more aware of in recent publications which actually acknowledge this, and PRP is being more slowly accepted. However, when it comes to the hair growth effect of PRP, I would say that what we've done in our practice for the past 7 years has actually taken this to the treatment of both hair loss and wound healing to a different level. What we have developed is something called hair regeneration. And where it's relevant, I'll be able to explain further. Years ago, when we were doing hair transplants and we wanted the grafts to heal better and we wanted the donor area to heal better, we were using a material called extracellular matrix. And we found that the wound healing improved, the grafts healed sooner, and in fact, growth of the hair grafts actually occurred earlier. But another interesting benefit was that thinning hair actually became thicker. So the cusp of finding an opportunity to help people with hair thinning without doing surgery. And that's what we did over the first several years, is developed a system of doing these injections using PRP, an extracellular matrix, and developed an algorithm and system to treat men and women with genetic pattern loss, as well as people with other conditions who have all related to hair loss. Now, when it comes to hair transplant, we've also been able to establish that when someone has a hair transplant, there is a window of opportunity, and I basically feel it's within the first 1 to 3 months that we can actually help that person's healing after the transplant. We can expedite the healing of the grafts, improve the healing of the tissue that's been traumatized by all of the surgical procedure, as well as help the thinning hairs, and often the hairs that could potentially have been compromised from the surgery. I'm talking about the native hairs that were basically in the same neighborhood as the grafted hairs, help improve that those hairs as well in terms of help them regrow and strengthen. Basically, on its own, without the transplant, hair regeneration, we've been able to show that we can stop progression, we can reactivate hair that is not currently growing, we can thicken hair that is thinning, as well as induce the shed of thinning hair and grow thicker hair. So when you ask the question of when can you do PRP, I would say you should allow the scabs and the top of the scalp to become more clear and stable. And I think that you can start as early as a month after the transplant. And I would say that you need to also at least understand that PRP, at least from my experience, PRP can probably help you with the healing process. But I have found that the treatment hair regeneration with PRP, with acellular matrix, this wound healing material, I didn't explain it earlier, a wound healing material that leverages your body's own ability to generate adult stem cells in a way that has really been a tremendous benefit when it comes to healing wounds in skin, on muscle, and in other areas. And for us, in terms of tissue quality, it has made a big impact in a lot of the surgical procedures we do. So this combination has been significant in changing the narrative of managing hair loss, as well as helping people who, regardless of whether we did their transplant or they had their transplant done elsewhere, have found the benefits of this wound healing technology. So I think you should just, of course, ask this question about PRP to your doctor, learn more about hair regeneration and acellular matrix, and become more knowledgeable, and then try to come up with a plan that will be suited for your situation. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.